we met and spent our first two nights in Naples, Florida. Next morning, we got fitted for our bikes by Amy and her very patient crew.
So it kind of goes up like that.
Then we took off for a 32-mile exploration of Naples, Florida. Checked out the pier and the beach over in the historic district. Fifth Street for lunch at Luna Cafe. Day two was another 23 miles or so as we bike from Naples to Fort Myers Beach. Our biking ranged from a bike lane on the road to a separate bike trail alongside the road, and sometimes just on the road. Into Lover's Key, Hung, one of the bike guides, entertained us. Then we did some cross training and walked about a mile to get to a pavilion on the beach for lunch. For a change of pace, we went biking on the 3-mile mountain bike trail. Day three, it was over to Sanibel and Captiva Islands for some wonderful biking. But first, everyone posed for a group photo, except for Edward, who's hiding behind someone. On Sanibel, all biking was on bike trails alongside roads. First stop was the lighthouse, where we were met by a Florida master naturalist, Marilyn, for a beach walk.
This is Sanibel, and this is not a very beautiful day here in Sanibel.
Obviously, the strong wind messes up the microphone on the camera, but as we walked the beach, she would pick up something, show it to us, and tell us what it was.
Thank you.
we biked over to the marvelous Island Cow restaurant for a wonderful lunch. I had the grouper tacos. They were out of this world. Our next stop was a tour of the Bailey Matthews Shell Museum, where we were given an hour's long tour of the public area as well as the upstairs workroom and storage area.
Just fantastic. Just a rainbow of colors. They just keep doing this until they're full. And you can see the winery coral of ropes. I always say this one would be a turtle. You know, they come down once a year to lay eggs in the water. Then they go back up. And they
on the end of their foot, and it kind of pushes them. And it kind of pushes them more backwards than forward. Here we go. And you can see that little foot. Now, if I pick him up, he's going to pull himself back in, so you won't be able to see.
It's, you own it. It's a pretty formidable, that's...
Right above his head.
Yeah. It's a coral? Is that a brain coral?
Coral.
That's a coral, yeah.
Okay.
Coral. A lot of the coral, you have some sponges up there. You have some sea urchins up there.
Then we biked over to the Ding Darling National Wildlife Refuge and biked the 4 mile wildlife road. After spending a wonderful evening at the very plush South Seas Island Resort, we had a private cruise over Pine Island Sound to reach Pine Island for more biking. Before biking, lunch at the waterfront restaurant.
And she greets me just like the sunrise. Nobody loves me like my dog.
Then it was 13 more miles of biking to the end of the island, so we could visit the Randall Research Center for a tour on the Calusa Heritage Trail. A flock of white ibis atop a 30-foot shell mound built by the Calusa 2,000 years ago.
The gumbo limbo tree, nicknamed the tourist tree, because it's red and peeling.
Our last evening together and our final dinner, this time at Michelli's restaurant on Pine Island, before driving back to Naples. Here's our intrepid crew of Road Scholar bikers, one last time.